want you to follow me down to the bottom, underneath the insane asylum. Keep your wits about you while you got them, cause your wits are first to go while you're problem solving. And my problem, we glorify those even more when they... My opinion, our culture can treat a loss like it's a win, and right before we turn on them, we give them the highest of praise and hang the banner from a ceiling, communicating further, engraving an earlier grave is an optional way. No.
Neon gravestones try to call. Neon gravestones try to call.
Don't get it twisted, it's with the people we praise who may have assisted. I could use the streams and extra conversations. I could give up and boost up my reputation. I could go out with a bang, they would know my name. They would host and post a celebration. My opinion will not be lenient. My opinion, it's real convenient. Our words are loud, but now I'm talking action. We don't get enough love, well they get a fraction. They say how could he go if he's got everything. I'll mourn for a kid, but won't cry for a king.
Neon gravestones try to call. Neon gravestones try to call for my bones. Call, call, call.
Promise me this, if I lose to myself, you won't mourn a day, and you move on to someone else. Promise me this, if I lose to myself, you won't mourn a day, and you move on to someone else. And awareness is beating a stigma that no longer scares us. But for sake of discussion and spirit of fairness, could we give this some room for a new point of view? And could it be true that some could be tempted to use this mistake as a form of aggression, a form of succession, a form of a weapon, thinking I'll teach them? Well, I'm refusing the lesson. It won't resonate in our minds. I'm not disrespecting what was left behind, just pleading that it does not get glorified. Maybe we swap out what it is that we hold so high. Find your grandparents or someone of age. Pay some respects for the path that they paved, to life they were dedicated. Now that should be celebrated.